Hello, this is Cristi. In this short video with Descript, I want to show you how you can change camera angles, or maybe you need to track someone on the video and you're doing a narrow video like a vertical one and the action is kind of moving off screen. Let me show you how you can use animation to keep the person in the view. So I did this video recently where I demonstrated the background blur effect by duplicating the videos. But as I was watching this video, I noticed that while those two guys or three guys are in the shot, as I'm getting close to the end of the video, I'm kind of losing them because they're drifting out of the shot like this. Look at that. So by the end of the video, they're all out of the shot. So I want to adjust the camera angle so that even at the end of the video, they're still in the view while they're in the same place, you know, during the rest of the video. So how do you do this? It's quite easy, and we will use animations. The way to do it is this. You go to the point where they start to drift off, like let's say about here, they start to drift off to the left side of the screen. And because they are both in a sequence, they are in the script track down here, both layers. And click on the timeline in the script track, and let's add an animation to that clip. And you can also make sure that you're adding the animation to the right layer by clicking on the video itself on the canvas. Your playhead is in the right position, right down there. And clicking on the canvas will allow me to add an animation to that layer. I'm not adding animation to the background layer. You could do that if you want to, but I'm adding it to the front video, to the one in the front, because that's the one I want to see. So as I have that selected, click animation, and I will just use a custom animation right there. And the animation in Descript is added from the place where the playhead is, and like a second or two or in the future, like it is. So that's where the video is. And I want to go to the keyframe at the end, select the keyframe at the end, and move it to where the guys are actually out of the screen, where the animation ends, right? So now here we go. At the end of it, they are out of the screen, kind of here. And with that in place, with that keyframe selected, double click on the video on the canvas, double click. This will get you into crop mode, and you see this grid here tells you you're in crop mode, but now you see the outline of the video actually goes out of the scene like that, and you can click and bring them back into view like that. Don't go too far. Here we go. They are in view now, and double click to exit that again. So now watch this. If I play from here, from before that animation, they are in the view, and now the camera starts to slightly move, and I'm keeping them in the view like this. There you go, right there. So that's how you shift the camera view and you keep your subject in. Now, Descript doesn't have automated camera tracking. It doesn't have auto reframing. It doesn't have any of those fancy effects that other programs do. So this is the only way you can keep the people in the frame while you are playing. So you can also add multiple animations to a clip. So if you go back in your video, for example, here, and you decide, well, you know, I would like to maybe make sure that the guy in the middle is in the middle to start, you know, like here, you can also, again, select it, click on it, go to animation, add another custom animation. It will be added at that point, you know, starting from the playhead, and then click on the second keyframe and kind of shift it left or right until the point where you want them to come back in the view. And double click on it, shift them in the like this, you know, double click, shift the video, and double click again to exit. And there you go. Now the video is going to move in the center and keep playing. So as it plays, you know, it's at some point it's going to hit the other animation. And because we changed the video, the new keyframe on the new animation is going to be changed also. But the guy is still in the middle there, so just play through and see what happens. And now as they're trying to get out of the screen, the next animation is going to keep them in there like that. So there you go. That's how you do it. And by the way, if you go back to the animations, if you want to edit the animations again, you know, click on the clip itself and you see the animation on the sidebar 1 and 2. Click on this little icon, edit keyframe, and it goes into the keyframe editing. So if you decide that you want to change one of them, like here, double click again and, you know, shift it, and you can press escape or double click again on this, and you are out of crop mode. That's how you do it. And using animation, sadly, it's not automated, but what are you going to do? I hope you enjoyed this video and it was useful. If you came here looking for this solution, I hope I've provided it for you. And also, feel free to check out my Media Makers Club, where I have Descript courses, Camtasia courses, and Q&A sessions free every week. I hope to see you there. Thank you again. And feel free to subscribe to my channel, give it a thumbs up, whatever you want to do. See you next time.